Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup and welcome to station number 5 where we are going to observe the joints in the shoulder region. And hopefully we understand that that's not just the shoulder joint or the glenohumeral joint, but also the AC joint or acromioclavicular joint. So real quick before I get into this, just looking at this, where you mainly just see the bony structures with a few of the ligaments, what view do you think we're looking in? And hopefully you are thinking we are looking at a posterior view, and we know that because we can see the spine of the scapula. The spine of the scapula is always posterior, and you can see that it is expanding in this region to form the acromion process or acromion. This is going to articulate with the clavicle to form the acromioclavicular joint. And this is a plane joint. It is very close to that point of the shoulder, and it is going to be superior to the glenohumeral or shoulder joint, which you can see right here. So you can see the head of the humerus and the glenoid cavity or glenoid fossa. You can see some of the ligaments in this region as well. So this is the glenohumeral, and you can see it is just inferior and a bit lateral to the acromioclavicular joint. Here we're looking at an anterior view. I know that because I can see some of the coracoid process right here. You see the nice smoother portion of the anterior portion of the scapula. I can see a bit of the long head of the biceps brachii tendon. Right underneath here would be that intertubercular sulcus where that's traveling. And so you can kind of see what this looks like with all the ligaments and the capsules associated with this. So you can't really see the glenoid fossa in this region because the articular capsule is completely surrounding the glenohumeral joint, which would be right here. And that's what it looks like. You can see how protected this region is. These few things we're not going to have you identify. These are ligaments associated with the AC and shoulder joints, but just for kind of for your knowledge, but not covered on an assessment, this in blue is going to be the coracoclavicular ligament. So if you have a very severe shoulder separation, the coracoclavicular ligament will be damaged. This is the AC ligament, and it's really a capsular ligament. It's just going to kind of surround the capsule of the AC joint. And this is going to be the coracoacromial, because this is the coracoid process right here. Remember, coracoid process is always anteriorly projecting, and this is the acromion. Now, this is what it looks like with the muscles still intact. Obviously, this is a pretty deep dissection in order to be able to see portions of the shoulder joint. And you can even see some of the rotator cuff muscles, specifically the more anterior one, because we're looking at an anterior view. This is the subscapularis. And you can see how its tendon basically just really starts to interweave, and you can't really tell the difference between the rotator cuff tendon and the actual articular capsule. That's what we mean by forming that rotator cuff around the joint, because it's really playing that huge role in terms of stability. You would see the same thing from a posterior view for those other three rotator cuff muscles. This is the coracoid process. This is the clavicle. This is acromion, just to kind of get our bearings. This is where the glenohumeral joint is located, and we're looking at the capsule right here. One thing I want you to note, and we didn't talk about it in much detail, but in the acromioclavicular joint, you actually have an articular disc that is associated with the acromioclavicular joint, similar to what you had in the temporomandibular joint. So you do have one in this region as well. And so this is what it looks like more in terms of a dissection without the dry bone. And this gives you an indication of just how deep you are, because we're looking at these fairly large arterial supply in this region as well. All right, so that is the acromioclavicular joint and the glenohumeral joint, your most proximal upper limb joints. We will continue our tour of the upper limb with the joints associated with the elbow region. Thank you for your time and attention.